The shutdown did begin on the very same day that one of the most critical pieces of the health care law began to take effect. Judy picks up the story from there.
This is the day that people can start enrolling for health insurance through new online marketplaces known as exchanges. In all, the federal government is running or partnering with local officials to run these in 36 states. The remainder of states and the District of Columbia are operating their own exchanges. People will be able to enroll through March, but there were plenty of glitches on day one. When many went to the federal website, healthcare.gov, to learn more, they often saw a screen that read, "Please wait. We have a lot of visitors on the site right now." Some state-run sites had similar problems, too. During his appearance in the Rose Garden, the president said heavy demand had something to do with that.
We found out that there have been times this morning where the site's been running more slowly than it normally will. The reason is because more than 1 million people visited healthcare.gov before 7 in the morning. To put that in context, there were 5 times more users in the marketplace this morning than have ever been on Medicare.gov at one time. That gives you a sense of how important this is to millions of Americans around the country. And that's a good thing. And we're going to be speeding things up in the next few hours to handle all this demand that exceeds anything that we had expected.
So it's not clear yet just how many people tried to sign up on the various exchanges around the country today, but we look at what we do know so far with two reporters who follow this story extensively, Julie Rovner of NPR and Louise Radnofsky of The Wall Street Journal. Welcome back to the NewsHour to both of you. So without talking about birds, and it's great to hear The Economist with the birds in the background, but how did it go today in general? Julie, what was the sense overall of how it went?
Well, classic good news, bad news story. I think the administration's biggest fear is that they would open up and nobody would show up, and that's definitely not what happened. Lots and lots of people tried to show up, and I think it overwhelmed the capacity of the exchanges to deal with them, both in terms of the websites and the call centers and places to try to get help. And it wasn't just the federal exchanges, it was the state-run exchanges, too. Everybody seemingly just got overwhelmed, so people had trouble getting on and getting in.
And Louise, the administration was reporting over 1 million people tried to look at the website before 7 o'clock. Why weren't they prepared?
Well, they've said now that it's 2.8 million since midnight tried to go on. We don't know with these people how many were journalists trying to see if everything was running smoothly or how many were people who were just interested as opposed to people who were actually trying to sign up for coverage or consider their options. But certainly the administration had said previously they didn't expect the sites would crash. They'd pointed to their success running the Medicare website. That's something the president mentioned earlier today. Clearly they didn't expect 2.8 million people. That's what they're saying. And they've had to add capacity over the day, but they didn't expect it this morning.
Julie, tell us more about the nature of the glitches. How much of it was just the crush, than the number of people trying to get on to the
site? Well, we had a call with federal officials late this afternoon, and we asked them that question. We didn't quite find out how much of this is that they just weren't ready and how much of it was just the overwhelming nature. They did say that this was 7 times more people than they've ever had on the Medicare website. So it really was a lot of people. And again, it wasn't just the federal website. It was state websites also. But there seemed to be particular places where people got hung up. You have to create an account to really get on to some of these websites and even start to compare some of the plans. And a lot of people got hung up at the security question place. You have to create an account and, you know, have some of these security questions, you know, what was your first car, what was your pet's first name. That seemed to hang a lot of people up. They couldn't tell us why those security questions seemed to stop so many people, whether that was a software problem or just a nature of too many people on the website problem. They say that, you know, by later in the day, it did seem that not all of the problems were being taken care of. So some of it does seem to have just been capacity. Again, a lot of people trying to get on this first day.
Louise, what would you add to what you could glean so far today? Because I know both of you have been talking with people around the country in terms of the glitches, the problems that people were having.
Well, in addition to hearing that it's been difficulty loading the website for many people and the security question hurdle that people have found when creating accounts, we have been hearing that not everybody who's tried to enroll in the federally facilitated exchange states has been able to do so. The administration says that some people have been able to enroll. We're saying that many people are not, based based on what we're hearing from insurers in these parts of the country. That seems to be more of a problem with the data hub itself, not a capacity issue with the website and not a software glitch, but something seems to be going wrong.
And it's not clear yet what it is?
It's not clear yet how many people, for example, are unable to complete their enrollments. But again, the administration says that some have been able to.
And you mentioned, of course, and we've made the distinction earlier, Julie, about the some of these exchanges are run by the states, but many more are run by the federal government in partnership with the states. Is there a difference in how they're running based on who's running them?
There seems to be, and some states are obviously running better. Some exchanges seem to be running better than others. Some of them seem to be having no problem with people getting on, creating accounts, but when they get to that last enrollment hurdle, they're having trouble. Now, it's important to say this is the first day. Not very many people were expected to actually enroll today. It's sort of like Christmas shopping season. This is kind of like Black Friday. You know, people are going in and looking around and seeing what's there. Remember, you don't actually have to sign up for coverage that starts in January until December 15th. So it's kind of surprising that people would really sign up and try to enroll today anyway.
And we should clarify, Louise, there's not a penalty. If people don't sign up today or even in the month of October, they're not penalized, are they?
No, January 1st is the date upon which you're supposed to have coverage or pay a penalty. In practice as well, there are some exemptions for people who have coverage for most of the calendar year of 2014. Conceivably, you could go a little past January 1st, but the administration is emphasizing the December 15th date for enrollment because by January 1st, you can actually have a policy that covers you for the first time that's subject to the requirements under the law and benefit from the subsidy if that's something you're eligible for.
And Julie, what kind of folks would have been looking at it to sign up today? These are people who don't have insurance right now. Is that right?
Pretty much. And, you know, the people, there was some concern that if there were a lot of glitches that people might get discouraged and not come back. But I think the people who were there today are the really motivated people. These are people who, you know, don't have insurance and really want it. Probably the people with pre-existing conditions who haven't been able to get it. So these are people who are likely to come back if they had problems today. And, you know, they're going to come back tomorrow or next week or next month. These aren't the, you know, the young people who are thinking, oh, I really should get insurance. Those people probably aren't going to show up until they're getting, you know, pushed by their parents. So the concerns about glitches discouraging people are probably not a big issue with this first day. These are very highly motivated people, frankly, that insurers are worried about signing up.
And Louise, what are you picking up about who's trying to sign up?
Well, interestingly, we're hearing that some of the people who have been going to the website today have been people who currently have Medicare or employer-sponsored insurance who are just curious about the offer. The exchanges are primarily aimed at people who don't have access to insurance through one of these ways already, either they're in the individual market or uninsured.
If you already have coverage and you mean looking to compare?
They're browsing, mostly, and they're probably not going through the sign-up process. If they were going through the sign-up process, then they'd probably be told at various points along the way things like they're not going to be eligible for a subsidy towards the cost of coverage and that the individual market probably, they'll figure out, won't offer them a better deal than what they already have.
Julie, just quickly, what is the administration looking for? How will they know that this is going successfully or not? I mean, we know they wanted to sign up several million, and we heard Paul's point about they really want to sign up these younger, healthy people.
That's right. Their goal for this first year is to get 7 million people signed up. They want 2.8 million of those to be younger, healthier people. There will be a lot of outreach, a lot of advertising, and they're, you know, hoping that the people, you know, that will not be discouraged by some of those negative ads. I think they're probably, you know, as frustrated as I'm sure they are by the glitches today, I'm sure they're pleased by the turnout. Again, some of these people are browsing and have no intention of signing up, but still a lot more people than they expected showed up today.
And quickly, Louise, so they are, and they're going to extra lengths to try to appeal to these young people still.
They are, and supporters of the law have put a lot of stock around Thanksgiving conversations with parents and Christmas, maybe even after people have completed their Christmas shopping to try to get them to sign up. So they're certainly emphasizing, and we've heard this an awful lot in the last few days, that this is a six-month marathon, not a sprint.
Louise Radnofsky, Julie Robner, we thank you.
You're welcome.